time today. That's a shame. So cute, it's so tiny. All in the position of draw me like your French girl. I guess I know now where we got the shape for the mirrors. This is like reminding me of Hercules. Chariot! This is Sparta! Surprisingly, no one's told me to turn off my camera, so hey, what? I don't know if I'm breaking the rules or not, so I don't know. Who cares? Galleries for 19th and 20th century European paintings and sculptures. Her face looks so creepy. She's staring into my soul. Such a funny looking lion. Looks so weird. And the part that I'm always excited to see, swords. It's so freaking quiet in here. That's why I'm whispering. I hope you don't find it creepy. Isn't it funny how when we see a picture of naked women, it's somehow provocative, yet when it's paintings, it's not. It's so odd. Look, it's Jesus and Mary. The part that always amazes me about looking into artwork at the museum is how incredibly detailed things are. Why
is a raven like a writing's desk?
I don't remember the rest of it. Oh, look. That right there is the inspiration behind Starbucks' logo. So beautiful and so huge in this place, like.
Let's go downstairs, shall we?
Here's a closer look at the siren behind Starbucks' logo. Those dogs look so sad. Like, why are we here? Interesting. Their faces are so creepy. Ugh. Haunt me in my nightmares.
Look, it's the portrait of Christopher Columbus,
the famous bastard who ruined the Indians' lives. It's so creepy, his eyes follow you everywhere. Excuse me, sir, but what are you doing? Just where exactly is your hand? Allegory of the planets and continents. I remember this painting from art history class. We had to study this one. Okay, I know this is rape, but this looks like a dance move. Just look at all of the detail they put into this painting. It is so freaking awesome. This is another one I remember from art history. Interior of St. Peter's, Rome. Central Park. This part of the museum is always a little creepy because not a lot of people come here. But it's like where all these furnitures are. this in my house. Harmonica. Did I just say harmonica? I meant harp. Wow. That was way off. Harmonica. Look at all the fancy chairs. An old school lounge chair. Here we have the row of grandfather clocks. So this would be like a fascinating section if you really like building furniture or something. It's really creepy to see the bust with no eyes. It's like really they can't be like this one and have pupils or something. Look, a centaur. Conveniently placed right next to a picture of horses jumping out of a frame. It's like, help me, my brethren. I'm one of you. This is so cool. It's like I want this in my house. There's like a little mini Buddha inside. That's so cute. It would be so terrible to like knock into one of these glasses and all this thing breaks. Like, there's a lot of really fragile furniture. In here. Look at all these pottery and vases. Hey look, it's George Washington. Or at least I think it's George Washington. I'm guessing because he has like eagles and American flags on the frame. And a row of older men that I don't know. So this really dark spot here is a period room where it basically shows you what the, I think, 1680 house would look like. It's really hard to see in here because it's so dark. And people were so short. It's like really dark in there, but it's supposed to show you like what a house looked like in the 1680s, and people were very short, so you can literally touch the roof of the house, and the beds were so small. Just like, but it's really dark, so I can't really show you very clearly what it looks like.
So that was the Met. It's pretty cool. Didn't get to film much of the fashion because you're not allowed to film in there, but whatever. If you want to come here, it's on 86th Street and 5th Avenue for the art museum and the history, which is seen in the film. The Night at the Museum is straight across, same address, but on the other side of the park. Walking through the street. So that was fun. Oh, so when you go to the museum, when you enter, they have the option of pay by donation, so you can pretty much pay whatever you feel like paying, which is awesome. They'll give you a sticker. I put it on my hand. You can put it on your shirt, whatever. But yeah, you can pretty much pay whatever you feel like paying. They say like a suggested amount is $25, but I gave them like $4. Just don't give them a penny. Don't be petty like that, because that's just rude. So I grabbed something to eat, and now I'm just like sitting out here in Central Park. It's really cold now, so I'm freezing, but Starbucks is kind of full, so I didn't want to like stay there and just be squished somewhere, so this air is nice. I don't mind. It's fine. Yeah, I got a green tea latte and a little lunchbox thingy. Just gonna eat this, and I think I'm gonna head home afterwards. Oh my gosh, my face hurts so much right now. I did so much walking today, it's not even funny. But I am finally home, as you can see, and I spent a long time in the museum, like 3 hours. Which is kind of like an average time to be in a museum, but it passes by so quickly because you're walking around, you're looking at so much stuff, which I couldn't capture all of it because that would just be a really long video. But it's just something you gotta see for yourself, especially if you're coming to New York. There's not much to do at the like Upper East Side area other than just seeing a bunch of apartment buildings and such. I mean, there's Madison Avenue, which is the shopping avenue. But unless you have a lot of money, I don't think that's the place you want to go. Because it's just a bunch of like really expensive shops and such. But you know, throughout this experience, I realized two things. One, I really enjoy going to places by myself. And two, I really like vlogging because instead of just taking a whole bunch of pictures of like stuff that I like and that I see, of like all the different artifacts and such and paintings, it's just so much easier to just videotape that all and just, you know, combine it into a video instead of just having a whole bunch of pictures taking up space in your phone. And those pictures that I take, looking back on it now, I never really show them to anybody, so vlogging was definitely a better way of capturing these memories instead of just taking a bunch of pictures, because although pictures are great, I'd rather be in the photo and not just take a bunch of pictures of artifacts. But that's just my own thing. I know everybody's different, but oh my gosh, it got so cold all of a sudden. I mean, it was cold in the morning, but it definitely got colder later on in the day, especially when I was in the park eating, because I realized that it was a mistake not to bring gloves. Anyway, I think I'm gonna say goodbye here, and I'm going to go eat dinner and take a shower, because I just want to get into bed and just rest. And probably just binge watch. objects.